Welcome back to Fundamentals of Conflict Resolution and Peacebuilding. Hopefully you have watched the documentary on South Africa's Truth and Reconciliation Commission. It's available for free through our library, and it is a very powerful movie regarding real world restorative justice and African peacebuilding. Now, historically, I was first asked to teach multicultural conflict resolution at UC Berkeley within peace studies, and I was thrilled. But when I came to Dominguez and saw that Marco Turk had created, we historically at Dominguez were a behavioral sciences program, and the focus was on win-win negotiation and conflict resolution, and primarily to train law enforcement and police officers. And I don't know how you can evaluate that at the moment. It's very discouraging and sad what we see. But Marco Turk came to head up our program and created, because he had just spent a Fulbright in Cyprus facilitating and empowering bi-communal peace-building dialogue between the Greek and the Turkish Cypriot people. And if you know any of the history, it's a very tragic example of how British colonization divided people, pitted people against each other, but also how politics will take and seize strategic locations. And really, you know, Greece and Turkey, they were at war with each other forever. So he came and created peacebuilding here, and what I discovered is that our local African-American community was particularly on fire about negotiation, conflict resolution, and peacebuilding. But they were also joined by many African students from a variety of African nations. And you are going to see some of their scholarship in writing in negotiation alchemy. You know, I have taught students from Cameroon, and the most powerful real-world case study of peace building in the midst of civil war has been from Cameroon. Students from Kenya, quite a few, and then Zambia, Nigeria. Let me think, who am I forgetting here? I've had a lot of students from Egypt. And so I would like to tell you that I have intimately experienced their passion for peace building and their resilience. And I'd like to share some of my thoughts on why they were so passionate about our program and my classes. Knowing the history of African Americans in this country, I see their faith as having led them through the worst of human experience, kept them strong and resilient. And so today I want to share some of the parallels. I'm going to focus on Christianity today. We could pick other faiths, because certainly my students have not all been Christian. I've had many Muslim students, a few Buddhists, you know, pick the range. I've taught a lot of different of the world faiths. But today I'm going to show you some of the parallels between Christian teachings and conflict resolution and peace building. I think you'll find it interesting. I also believe that is what you see in this documentary, where Africans were the most likely, Black Africans were the most likely to participate in truth and reconciliation. And they really gave us inspirational examples in the midst of horrific, you know, tragic violence, as you'll see. We do have an example. Some white American parents also are inspirational examples. So it's not just the Black Africans, but I want to focus on them as we explore my PowerPoint. You know, Gandhi said, "I love your Jesus Christ, but I don't like you Christians." And what he was saying is that the Christian gospel and the example of Jesus Christ are truly inspirational for conflict resolution and peace building through the worst of oppression and darkness, tragedy. But so many of the people who profess the Christian faith are simply not living that example. So let's look at some of the parallels with my PowerPoint. Hate the sin, not the sinner. Now, some of this is quoting from Gandhi and how he saw Christianity. Well, conflict resolution and peace building says separate the people from the problem. Attack the problem, not the people. Very much a parallel. Love your enemy. We do a lot in conflict resolution and peace building to reframe hostile language to pull out human need. So we are looking to respond unconditionally to the best of human beings. Service and sacrifice are truly the best of Christianity, I think you would agree. And I've recently talked about generous tit for tat, extending an olive branch. This is the unconditional love that Jesus Christ emulated, that regardless of what someone has done, especially if they have been outcast and despised in society, they are deserving of love, right? That's what we see in the Christian gospel. Recognition of all human beings. And I will be talking shortly, I think it will be next week, if not next week, the following, about impartiality, which is how conflict resolvers and peace builders include everyone concerned equally, treat everyone equally. It's quite radical, really, as radical as Jesus Christ was in his day. He scorned the rich, the greedy, the wealthy, right? The hypocrites. And he reached out to those that others were scorning. But in our program, we teach you how to balance power. Very important practice for peace building. We cannot have true democracy in this world unless all are included and respected, and we share power with each other. We can't do what we see in popular society around the world with class and caste and gender and all of it. We have to be radically different. So I hope you've enjoyed this little brief introduction to how the Christian faith parallels the best of conflict resolution and peace building. Thanks.